Hallelujah. Come on, magnify the Lord with me on today. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Listen, I just got to dance before the Lord on this morning. Hallelujah. Because how good he has been. Hallelujah. Come on. I want you to just get in the middle of your floor. And I just want you to dance before the Lord on this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You ain't got to do nothing fancy. All you got to do is sway from side to side. Hallelujah. Glory to God. All you got to do is wave your hand because he's been so good, because he's been so kind. Hallelujah. He's been a loving father. Hallelujah. He's been a father that has covered you. So I know you got to dance for him on this morning. Hey, get in your kitchen. Go ahead. Cut that two-step for Jesus. Glory to God. We're going to be like Luther Vandross. We're going to dance with our father today. Come on. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, we bless you, God. We honor you. We magnify you. We glorify you. We lift up your name, oh God. Hallelujah. We command our limbs to give you praise on this morning. We command our feet to move. We command our hands to be lifted up. Hallelujah. We glorify you on today, Lord. Woo! Because he's been so good. Are you excited this morning? Are you excited because he has brought you to December? Oh, my God. Hallelujah. My God, this is the year where you need to celebrate. If you woke up, hallelujah, on this morning, if you got breath in your lungs, oh, this is the time where you need to glorify him because he's been so good. Because it's been the blood of Jesus that was upon your life that you are standing here today. So you might as well go ahead and give him praise. Hallelujah. My God, my God. It shouldn't take much to stir you up in these days. My Lord, your God. If you got food on the table, you should be stirred up. Hallelujah, Jesus. If you got something to put on your back, you should be stirred up. My God, I thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We magnify him and we glorify him, for this is the day, hallelujah, that he has made. And he has allowed you to see. He has allowed you to be a part of it. So go ahead and give him praise right where you are. Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. We glorify you, God. Woo! My Lord and God. I just thank him on this morning. Hallelujah. I give him praise. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for joining us on this morning. You could have went to any virtual church, but you decided to come here to Sozo Life Ministry, and we appreciate you, and we love you. Hallelujah. I give honor, hallelujah, to God on this morning, my Lord, because he's been so good. My Lord, hallelujah. Sometimes, you know, when you talk about God and you just get excited, you just got woo. You just got to kind of stop yourself, my God, because you're getting ready to take off somewhere, because you're beginning to think of the goodness of Jesus. I know now what the old saints used to say, that when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. My God, I thank you for saving me. My God, I know what the old saints was talking about. My Lord the King is not a feeling, but it's an experience, my God. Woo! When you walk with him, hallelujah, and you see how he moves in your life, my God. It's an experience with him, my Lord. Hallelujah. And I just thank him on this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I give honor to my overseer and to my pastor on this morning. Hallelujah. And I want y'all to just pray with me on this morning as this message comes forth. And you know what? The Lord has said it through Pastor E when he said, change some perspectives on this morning. And I believe that that's what this word here is. God wants to change your perspective on some things. So I want you to bear with me as we read through the scriptures. Amen. And we're going to be coming from Numbers. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We're starting at the 13th verse. We're going to start. We're going to go ahead and read. We're going to read at the first through the third. And then we're going to jump down to the 17th, to the 17th verse. Amen. Hallelujah. Because we're not going to go ahead and name all those tribes on this one. You can read that on your own. Amen. Hallelujah. So the word of God says, the Lord said to Moses, send some men to explore the land of Canaan, which I am given to the Israelites from each ancestral tribe, and sit on one of its leaders. So at the Lord's command, Moses sent them out from the desert of Paran. All of them were leaders of the Israelites. Hallelujah. We're going to jump on down to 16. These are the names of the men Moses sent to explore the land. Moses gave Hosea, son of Nun, the name Joseph. 17, when Moses sent them to explore Canaan, he said, go up through the Negev and on into the hill country. See what the land is like and whether the people who live there are strong or weak, few or many. What kind of land do they live in? Is it good or is it bad? What kind of towns do they live in? Are they unwalled or fortified? How is the soil? Is it fertile or poor? Are there trees on it or not? Do your best to bring back some of the fruit of the land. It was the season for the first ripe grapes. 21, so they went up and explored the land from the desert of Zin as far as Rehob, toward Lebo, Hammon. Praise God, pray with me through these names. They went up through Negev and came to Hebron, where Aman, Sheshar, and Talmai, and the descendants of Anak lived. Hebron had been built 7 years before Zoan in Egypt. 23, when they reached the valley of Eshcol, they cut off a branch bearing a single cluster of grapes. Two of them carried it on a pole between them, along with some pomegranates and figs. That place, hallelujah, was called the Valley of Eshcol because of the cluster of grapes the Israelites cut off there. At the end of 40 days, they returned from exploring the land. Come on, I want you to stay with me now. 26, they came back to Moses and Aaron and the whole Israelite community in Kadesh in the desert of Paran. There, they reported to them and to the whole assembly and showed them the fruit of the land, that it was good. Huh? 27, they gave Moses this account. We went into the land to which you sent us, and it does flow with milk and honey. They saw it for themselves. Here is its fruit, but the people who live there are powerful, and the cities are fortified and very large. We even saw descendants from Anak there. The Amalekites lived in the Negev, and the Hittites and Jebusites and Amorites live in the hill country, and the Canaanites live near the sea and along the Jordan. It sounds like a little fear is trying to creep in, huh? Then Caleb silenced the people before Moses and said, we should go up and take possession of the land, for we can certainly do it. 31, hang on in there with me, y'all. We're going somewhere. But the men who had gone up with him said, we can't attack those people. They are stronger than we are. And they spread among the Israelites a bad report about the land they had explored. They said, the land we explored devours those living in it. All the people we saw there are the great size. We saw the Nephilim, where the descendants of Anak come from. The Nephilim, we seemed like grasshoppers in our own eyes, and we looked the same to them. Hallelujah. Lord God, we thank you for this word. Holy Spirit, have your way and preach this word in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, lately, Pastor E has been speaking on order and obedience. Amen. And so this morning's message is within that same thing. So here we have the Israelites. And just to give you just a little bit of narrative, they were rescued from bondage in Egypt from Pharaoh. Since the beginning, God spoke a word of a promised land that was going to be flowing with milk and honey that he had already established for them. Amen. Now, we know the story of a man being chosen, that man being Moses, to go and get the Israelites from out of Egypt. So Moses wasn't qualified for the job. However, through his obedience of following God's instructions on how to deal with Pharaoh, God equipped him, right? You know the story. Hallelujah. So these people saw how God brought plagues that affected the Egyptians, but not the Israelites. They witnessed how God parted the waters so that they can walk on dry land and escape the Egypt army. They were recipients of the daily manna that showed up in the morning's dew in order for them to eat in the desert. You remember that? Hallelujah. Now, along with that, they also witnessed the miracle of the water coming from out of the rock. They knew God was with them because the cloud led them by day and the fire by night. And let's not forget the countless prayers that Moses prayed on their behalf so that God wouldn't destroy them because of their constant complaining. My God. But unfortunately, here we have another example of the Israelites' disbelief, their fear, and their overall lack of faith in God to where he was trying to take them. My God. And you may be asking yourself, well, Minister Ron, where are you trying to go with this? Well, Holy Spirit wants to enlighten our perception of sightseeing. My God. That's right. Sightseeing. And we're going to use that for a topic on today. My God. And so the general definition for sight I read is the faculty or power of seeing, which is vision, huh? I want you to follow me. Now, see, the definition that I chose from out of the Webster's, good Google, was to discern visually. So what are you saying? In this walk with Christ, we have to stay sightseeing. We have to know and remember where God has brought us from, what he brought us out of, how he delivered us out of Satan's grips, right? Those are our testimonies. That's the faculty of seeing, because you were there and you were a witness to what he has already done in your life. My God, you saw how he brought you out of darkness. You saw how he made ways where you had exhausted all of your resources. You saw how he got you out of situations, especially ones that you got yourself in. My God, you saw how he turned your life around when you was in a life of sin. You saw it. You were a witness to it. You had the sight of that thing. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And on that same accord, you have to visually discern where he is trying to take you. And don't allow your present situation make you lose sight and cloud your vision to see. Now we're talking about discernment here. You got to see where you're going. My God, we're talking about sightseeing on this morning. Now, 2020 is definitely one for the books. It caused a lot of death. It caused a lot of lack. It caused a lot of disappointment, and it caused some discouragement. But this is the present time. This present time has no bearing on the fact that God is taking you somewhere. Oh, he's taking you somewhere. He's got a place that's already prepared for you. Are you ready to go? My God, do you got sight to see? Hallelujah. For we walk not by sight with our physical eyes, but by faith, my God, hallelujah, with each step that we take, hallelujah, it's got to be a faith walk in this thing, y'all, hallelujah, and understand that God has prepared a place for you here on earth. You ain't got to die. He got a place prepared for you when you leave this earth, but he also got a place prepared for you right here in the earth, and that place is your promised land in the earth, my God. It's the promises of God, y'all. Hallelujah. It's the promises of God. I want you to go ahead and put in a comment, oh, I got some promises. Oh, he made some promises. Hallelujah. I don't know what your promise is. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Go ahead and put in your comments, I don't know what your promises is. I know what my promises is. Your promises could be that degree. Hallelujah. Glory to God that you've been looking online. Hallelujah. Every month, every 2 months. It's all under your spirit, but you ain't made a move on it yet. Hallelujah. That could be your promise. Your promise could be that business. Hallelujah. When you wrote that business plan out 2 years ago, it's a good business plan. All you got to do is put some fire to it. Hallelujah. All you got to do is walk towards it. Hallelujah. That promise could be that global ministry. I don't know. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You're doing real good on Facebook. Your numbers is up. So it might be that global ministry. My God, today. I know he's made a promise to you. Then you got to remember that promise and you got to walk towards that promise. Oh, I'm sightseeing on today, y'all. Do I got any sightseers in the house? Are there any sightseers in the room? Hallelujah. Oh, I have sight. I have seen the goodness of the Lord and all that he has done for me. I am a witness. Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
Glory to God. I am a witness of his glory. I am a witness of his love. My God. Hallelujah. I thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Let me get back to the text. Hallelujah. I'm making myself a little bit too excited. My God. Hallelujah. Now, at this point, hallelujah, the Israelites were camped in the desert of Paran, and the Lord gave Moses instructions to send the men. Remember when we read that, to Canaan, to explore the land. Now, the Bible says in verse 18 that Moses gave instructions to see if the land was good, or if it was bad, if it was unwalled or fortified, was the soil good, are there trees there? And if I was to use my imagination for just a little bit, it's just my imagination. This is not the word of the Lord. Amen. So don't take it seriously. Hallelujah. But from the beginning, God did say and did tell them that I'm taking you to a place that is flowing with milk and honey. In other words, all the provisions have been made in order for you to prosper in that land. Now, I'm inclined to believe that God said, go and explore, that he meant, go take a look, go take a gander, go take a peek at what I have in store for you. Just a little something to get you excited and ready to go and take the land. But the instructions that Moses gave exhibited just a little bit of opening of doubt. And listen, when you have been in a desert place and God is revealing to you that he has a place that is promised to you, there is no room for doubt, my sister. There is no room for doubt, my brother. Hallelujah. This year has felt like a desert place for most people. So why would God promise you a land that was bad? Why would he take you to a place where you couldn't build? Why would he set you up where fruit could not be produced? God is a good father. Hallelujah. He's a father that knows how to take care of his children. He's a father who knows how to provide. Hallelujah. And he's a father that goes before us. Hallelujah. So my God, hallelujah, he's taking you to a place that is flowing. In other words, in the words of T.D. Jakes, you better get ready. You better get ready. You better get ready. Uh-huh. But hey, you know, we're going to give Moses just some grace here. We're going to give him just a little bit of grace because, after all, he was surrounded by people that complain all the time, which is a characteristic of doubt. Listen, let me just throw this plug in here to you. If you got negative people around you, you need to separate yourself, because these times, these perilous times right now, we can't have negativity around us. Hallelujah. We got a battle of our own versus the fact of having to battle somebody that's always pushing some negative stuff to you. My God, it's the time to pray. Hallelujah. It's the time to stay focused. My God, because God is trying to take you somewhere. So don't find yourself being that person that's complaining. Hallelujah. You need to keep on being a sightseer, knowing where God has brought you from, and walk by faith as to where he is taking you. He's taking you somewhere. Uh-huh. Hallelujah. And when the men return from what the Bible states was a 40 days journey, they brought back custom of grace that it took two men to carry on the pole. Those were some huge grace. Y'all, that was huge. It took two men on a pole to carry those grapes. My God, hallelujah. They reported that the land was indeed flowing with milk and honey. But they lost sight of the promise because of who they saw was currently inhabiting the land. Let me tell you something. Don't be afraid of the people that's just holding your spot. Oh, my God, hallelujah. They just holding your spot. My God, they just keeping it up until you come and take possession of the land. Now, you can give it to them because you can never, ever show up. My God, but they are only there just to hold the spot, just to keep it fertile, just to keep it producing until you get there and take possession of the land. they reported that all of the ice was there. Mm-hmm. There were a company occupying the land. The Amalekites were there. Now, I don't even know why they were worried about the Amalekites, because they defeated the Amalekites back in the battle that was described in Exodus 17. You remember when Moses held up his hand? As long as his arms was held up, that God was battling for them. My God said, why are you afraid of the Amalekites? Y'all already beat them. But I digress, because I was in there. When I was doing this, I said, Lord, I don't understand why the Israelites do some of the things that they do. But God has shown them already that he was mighty in battle. So come on. They saw the Hittites and the Jebusites and the Amorites and the Canaanites and all of them what happened in the land. And they feared they couldn't go against these people. They also reported that the word has spread around that the land devours those that live in it. Listen, I'm going to tell you something. Now, they saw that for themselves, that the land was full with milk and honey. They experienced themselves that they brought back the grapes, hallelujah, where two men had to carry. Now, you mean to tell me that you're going to allow somebody to get in your ear and tell you something that you already saw with your own eyes and deter you and put fear in you? Let me tell you something. You better turn away from those people, because they see God moving in your life. They see that God is taking you somewhere. So they're going to put some stuff in your ear, hallelujah, to bring fear. But listen, as long as you keep your sight, hallelujah, my God, and as long as you keep seeing, you can talk all you want, baby. But I already know, and I've already experienced this God, my Lord the King. So talk all you want to, my God. Don't you let nobody talk you out of your promises. Hallelujah. Don't you let nobody talk you out of your promises. My God, come on now. And if we want to be honest with ourselves, we've allowed what we saw in the natural to stop us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Remember, y'all, we're not walking by sight. We're walking by faith. Hallelujah. The Bible already warns us of these things, wars against wars. They're going to be diseases. Hallelujah. They're going to be earthquakes. Hallelujah. Mothers against daughters. Hallelujah. The Bible has already prepared us for this. He's already said, so this should not shake you. Hallelujah. From where God is trying to take you. Hallelujah. You got to keep moving towards your promises. So listen, Satan is going to get a reprieve on this message, because it's time for us to do a self-check. Hallelujah. We got to stop blaming Satan for everything. Hallelujah. We got to take self-inventory. Yes. Yes. We got to take self-inventory. Hallelujah. Because sometimes we get in our own way of what God is trying to take us. Hallelujah. And the promises of God are what? Yes and amen. However, they don't come without us having to do our part. And our part is to stay in communication with God, get the instructions, obey, and execute the plan. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That's our responsibility. Stay in communication with God, get those instructions, obey. Hallelujah. Some of us stop and obey. Hallelujah. Some of us are holding on to some instructions. Glory to God. And you're looking at your instructions and you're saying, okay, Lord, this is a stretch. Hallelujah. This is a stretch. Glory to God. But you got to obey. And you got to execute the plan. Hallelujah. You can't let no slick talking, smooth shooter, fast mouth, gift of gab, nobody should be able to keep you from what's yours. Hallelujah. That's including yourself. My God, as Pastor E always said many times before, 2020 still owes us some stuff. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. It ain't over yet. My God, you still got some stuff out there. You still got some promises. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I just hope you got sight to see. Glory to God. What God has in store for you. It ain't over yet. Hallelujah. You ready to walk into 2021. Hallelujah. But God still got something for you in 2020. Glory to God. I want you to go ahead and type in the comments. Oh, I still got some stuff. I still got some stuff. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And And as long as your eyes are open and breath remains in your body, you better go for what's yours. Hallelujah. I know I'm going for what's mine. My God. Oh, I'm sightseeing in this last quarter, y'all. Yes, hallelujah. And yes, there is an inhabitant in the land. And yes, it's a giant. And it's called COVID. But just like the Israelites experienced in Egypt, we got the blood on us. Hallelujah. It's the blood of Jesus, my God. Oh, I'm blooded on today, y'all. It's the blood of Jesus, my Rabboshah. Glory to God. Do you got the blood on you today? Hallelujah. Hallelujah, my God. It's the blood of Jesus. Woo, my God. Hallelujah. Are there any sightseers in the house? Woo, my Rama Shiki and Rabosha. That's about all that I have for you today, but I wish I had some sightseers up in here. Somebody that can praise him because they remember what God has done. Somebody that can encourage themselves in the mere fact that God spoke into their lives. Oh, I wish I had somebody that could just get excited because they are headed to a place that is flowing with all that they need. My God, today I wish you would get excited because you can see where God is taking you. Go ahead and give him glory right there. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter what it looks like all around you. And I know it gets hard because that's all that you see before you. But if you get in this word, oh my goodness, stop. If you get on your knees, God will begin to change your vision. Woo! That it won't matter what you see with your natural eyes. Oh my God, hallelujah, but he will give you a vision to where he is trying to take you. Hallelujah, my God. You need God's vision in this hour. Hallelujah, Jesus. Are there some sightseers? Are you focused on the promise? And don't be afraid to take it by force. Because when God is with you, woo, my God, who can be against you? My God, he stands as a strong tower. My God, today. So don't be afraid to take it by force. Because if he promises to you, that it's yours. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. He's already gone before you. So do you have sight today? Can you see? Woo! Can you see what God is doing? And I need you to stay with it, saints. I need you to stay the course. My double kasa. You can't live in a desert place for too long. And going back is not an option. Fear has no place in this journey. Doubt cannot be a part of this moving forward. And the naysayers, they are irrelevant. Master kora basa. And just like that cluster of grapes where it took two men to carry, God got some big things, baby, for you. Woo! Are you excited? He's got some big things that's waiting for you. Can you see it? Hallelujah. And as I close, I want to leave you with this. That old song. God did not bring you this far just to leave you. So get yourself ready to walk, y'all. Get yourself ready to walk in your promised land. Get yourself ready to walk into your promises. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I pray that this word has been a blessing to your soul because it has blessed me tremendously. Any sightseers in the house? Hallelujah. Walk into your promises. Stay blessed.